I have a 70-foot tall tree in my backyard and I want to string an HF wire antenna over it. I didn't use this, I used this. As tech-savvy as ham radio operators tend to be, you'd think we'd always be looking for the most advanced technical solutions to our problems. So I figured I'd give up the Stone Age antenna deployment equipment and take a shot at using some of the more advanced technology that's come out basically in about the last 10 years. This is a DJI Mavic 2 Pro drone with the aftermarket kit that I bought off of Amazon. And I'll leave a link below, but a search will probably get better results because there's a couple of different models. This is a two payload or a two drop model. They come with single drop payloads as well. We'll take a walkthrough to show how to set it up and actually use it in deploying a wire antenna. I have to redo my wire antennas at home, so this will give me a chance to experiment with it. So if you get anything out of this video or any of my videos, please hit the subscribe button and also click on the like. It does help promote my videos in the searches. So this is what you get in the kit. It's basically, you get leg extensions, so you raise the drone off the ground a little bit more to accommodate for whatever payload you have. This is the actual release mechanism. This is a sensor cable that will connect to the front LED, the driving lights, they call them the headlights. And then two attaching straps to strap the cable to the arm, a little rubber band to hold the sensor on. Putting it together is fairly straightforward. We take the actual payload release mechanism. It's got an arrow on here to show which direction to have it. And we slip it over the drone. And it snaps in place. That's the mechanism. Extensions for the front legs, two for the front, two for the rear, so now it sits up fairly high. And so the sensor just clips right over the front headlight. Get it on there correct. It snaps on. Then there's a rubber band that you run over the leg. It's a little, just stretches over and you just kind of place it over the sensor. Sensor wire comes back and plugs in to the side up here on the controller for the release mechanism. And this is very important. We use these two straps to tie down that cable. Very important, because if that cable during flight were to fly up and get caught in the propeller, it would potentially be catastrophic for the flight, for your drone, for whatever your payload is, and possibly for people on the ground. And that's it. She's ready to go. So the remote control, the payload release is actually set. You configure one of these two auxiliary buttons on the back, C1 or C2, to actually trigger the release. To do that, first what I want to do is we come into the camera settings here, the lines over here are underneath the start button. And we go to headlights auto turn off. What happens when you start recording or taking pictures, the headlights would automatically turn off. And so we want to turn that off because we want to manually do this, not automatically. And then we go into the general configuration, go on the top, advanced settings. Turn on head LEDs. We want to turn that off again because we want to do this manually. And then we go to the controller section and we scroll down to button customization. And I'm using C2 because I'm right-handed and I like the camera forward and down option on the C1 button. So I'm going to use the C2 button. And then we come up to the top, and it's the first one on the list. Turn on or off head LEDs. And there we go. And so now the C2 button, which is the one on the right, is configured to actually release. Let me give it a test here. So the first thing to do is actually turn on the device, and it'll blink a few times and then it'll go steady red, and then we're ready to go. So I flip it over and I'm using the C2 button on the back, and I click once and the first one opens up. I click again, the first one closes and the second one opens. So that's the second payload drop, and then press a third time and they're both closed. And here's my payload. It's a bullet shot for fishing, 8 ounces of lead, and just a little hanger there to through the hole to hold it in place. A ring that will actually clip on to the payload release. And then I've got 50-pound fishing line, which will be the feed line that I drop over the tree. And then I'll connect the end of this to the final rope and hoist that through. And this is the payload attached to the bottom of the drone. Tie off the fishing line to my rope for the. Alright. Here's our weight coming through the string. And this is the final result, an ICOM auto antenna tuner feeding 72 feet of wire. We had a bit of wind there, so I got to clean off that Spanish moss. A weight at the end, maintain tension on the antenna so it stays taut. Plus some flexibility for when the wind blows and the tree sways, that it has some space to move. Well, that's the setup and deployment of my payload drop device here, and using it to install my antenna in a very tall tree that I think the tree made up to 70 feet, I think, is what the drone was showing as the altitude up towards the upper limbs of the tree. One thing I did learn, get out of this, was to turn off the bottom sensors, the obstacle avoidance or the ground sensor, because the payload underneath swinging back and forth a little bit affects the bottom sensor. And so the drone tends to detect something below it and it wants to rise up. But I just got an error. It didn't go into a uncontrolled elevation. It just gave me an error code. So if you're going to try something like this, just an extra word of caution. Anytime you have string, cord, fishing line near rapidly spinning propellers, there's a high risk of entanglement in the propellers if you don't take appropriate precautions. So just please plan accordingly and take good safety precautions in having any kind of string or filament around the propellers. So the cost of this drone, if you're just to go out and buy one for this purpose, probably a bit prohibitive for using just for deploying antennas. It's anywhere $1,500 to $2,000 for a new Mavic 2 Pro. They already have the Mavic 3 out, so maybe these will be going for a little bit less. But they also have these devices for the first Mavic Pro that came out, and an equally good drone. It just doesn't have all the sensors and some of the bells and whistles that the more advanced models, the subsequent models have. But you can find them cheap, used, and they do have these devices specifically for the Mavic Pro as well. And so that might be a cheaper way to go. For those that are in the US, just be aware that the FAA, the Federal Aviation Administration, does regulate the flying of drones, just like the FCC regulates ham radio. So if you're gonna pursue this, whether for personal use or for a commercial endeavor, just make sure that you're read up on the rules and regulations for flying. Stay on the good side of the FAA. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. And as always, 73's best wishes.